When you just start your photography business, a very hard thing to do is to find your look, to find your style, to find the aesthetic that really suits your creative spirit the best. And the only piece of advice I have is that you just need to create more. You just need to create more, and I think that your style will find you. So here are some of the ways that I found my signature aesthetic. I followed people whose work I loved. I followed artists whose work I adored, and I found that the majority of them were film photographers. The more that I dug, the more that I realized they were all using medium format cameras. The majority of them were using a film stock called Fuji 400H, and they were overexposing that film 1 to 2 stops. That gave a very creamy pastel color tone. They shot with incredibly shallow depths of field, usually completely wide open, and it just created this ethereal, dreamy, pastel, extremely romantic aesthetic that I personally was drawn to. I would study the sources of light in their image. A lot of times it was backlit. A lot of times the pictures were taken at golden hour, at sunset. So there was a lot of consistencies in the way that all of these artists were photographing their subjects that I was studying and that I would try to emulate into my own work. So I would also study the elements of why I loved that picture. What was the composition like? What were the color tones like? Where is the source of light? What light are they using? Is it natural? Is it artificial? Is it side lit? Is it back lit? Is it front lit? You know, how is that translating into the photograph and what is making that photograph interesting for me? And I kept practicing. I was consuming all of that art, trying to dissect what I loved, trying to emulate that in my own work. A really big thing for me, I only photographed horses, but I filled my feed with all these wedding photographers who were doing these very dreamy engagement sessions and the most incredible wedding images, and everything was very romantic, and they were constantly telling a love story. And I really just kind of removed the groom from the posing or the composition or whatever I loved about that image and just inserted a horse. I wanted that same dreamy, pastel, romantic, backlit aesthetic to tell the story of a girl and the love that she had for her horse instead of a man and a woman who are in love. So I learned, on medium format film, shooting 400H in a very similar way to all of what they were photographing. And I felt like when I had more confidence in that is when I started learning a lot more into how to edit my digital work to match that film work. And then I was a hybrid shooter for many years where I was shooting both film and digital. The last couple of years I've been predominantly digital. And I still follow those artists and I fill my feed with the aesthetic that I'm very personally inspired by. And then, like I said, I just try to apply that to my own work in my own way, to create my look, which is my style. So, another big part is diving into outfits that serve your style very well, color palettes that serve your style very well, because the components of an image are the composition, are the lighting, are the sources, but also the subjects. And so what they're wearing conveys so much in the image and affects your posing, it affects the tones, it affects everything. So really dissecting work that you love, figuring out why you like that, and then so much practice and so much personal work so that you can fill your portfolio and all of your advertising work with a very specific look that you love. That way you can attract clients who are going to be inspired by a similar aesthetic.